और ए सिंगल क्वेश्चन कैन डिसाइड वेदर यू आर इन और आउट फॉर द कमिंग मेंस एग्जामिनेशन. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट पर्टिकुलर सिंगल क्वेश्चन विच कैन हेल्प यू क्लियर प्रीलिम्स दिस ईयर. एंड द क्वेश्चन इज रिगार्डिंग द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ जुडिशियल रिव्यू. एंड द क्वेश्चन इज विथ रेफरेंस टू द इंडियन जुडिशियरी द पावर ऑफ जुडिशियल रिव्यू इज वेस्टेड विथ वन सुप्रीम कोर्ट, टू हाई कोर्ट, थ्री डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोर्ट. सेलेक्ट द करेक्ट आंसर यूज इन द कोर्ट्स बिलो. So here the concept is regarding judicial review. So judicial review is nothing but examining the constitutionality. That is examining the constitutionality of the legislative enactments or executive orders of both central and state governments. I repeat once again, judicial review is nothing but examining the constitutionality of legislative enactments or executive orders of both central and state governments. That means if a law or an executive order is made by the government which is violating the fundamental rights or which is against the principle of basic structure doctrine. That is, if a law or executive order made by the central government is violating the provisions of fundamental rights or it violates the provision of basic structure, then the higher judiciary can strike down those laws or executive orders as unconstitutional. This power of judiciary is called judicial review. And please note that even though the term judicial review is not mentioned in the constitution, the articles like Article 13, Article 32 and Article 226 confers this power called judicial review on Supreme Court and High Court. That means, see, Article 13 defines what is a law. And 13 says that if a law is violating the principles of fundamental rights, then that law can be declared as null and void. And Article 32 is regarding the writ jurisdiction of Supreme Court. And Article 226 is regarding the writ jurisdiction of High Court. So even though the term judicial review is not clearly mentioned in the Constitution, the articles like 13, 32, 226 confers the power of judicial review on Supreme Court and High Court. That means if a law is made inconsistent with the fundamental rights, that is if a law is made which is contrary to the principles of fundamental rights, or if a law is made which is violating the basic structure of the Constitution, then the higher judiciary, that is the Supreme Court or the High Court, can declare that law or executive orders as unconstitutional. Fine, please note, this power is vested only with the Supreme Court and High Court. Now moving on to the question, with reference to the Indian judiciary, the power of judicial review is vested with Supreme Court, High Court, District Court. So we learned that this power of judicial review is vested with only in Supreme Court and High Court, and District Court has no power of judicial review, or subordinate courts, any of the subordinate courts have no power of judicial review, right? So our answer becomes option B, that is 192. That means only Supreme Court and only High Courts have the power of judicial review. That means only those Supreme Court and High Court can examine the constitutionality of legislative enactments and executive orders of both central and state governments. Okay, so answer is option B, that is 192 only. And if you feel this video useful, please share it to your fellow aspirants and also subscribe our channel for more quality videos. Thank you.